I am absolutely outraged that I learned today that that Port Authority, whom I have appeared before for 4 months now, sat there silently, never answered, that today, finally, they answered Senator Rockefeller and said there was no evidence of a traffic study. They sat there for 4 months. Every single New Jersey commissioner, I would say, is in dereliction of their responsibility to the people we all represent in New Jersey, particularly the people I represent in my area, including Fort Lee and Englewood and Leonia and Teaneck and all the surrounding towns, Palisades Park, that suffered through those traffic jams. This is horrendous.
Who created that false report, that suggestion that there was some sort of traffic study underway?
That was done by the deputy executive director of the Port Authority, Mr. Bill Baroni, an appointee.
He resigned,
but he resigned after he went on November 25th to the Assembly Transportation Committee, not under subpoena nor under oath, went voluntarily, and claimed that there was a traffic study and that this was an issue of fairness because somehow there were some kind of private roads from Fort Lee to the George Washington Bridge. Absolutely a made-up cover-up, and I've been saying it since then. So the fact that I've appeared before the Port Authority, these are men who are supposedly responsible for the biggest infrastructures in our region, for the safety, for the new building, for transportation project, for hundreds of thousands of people, and for hundreds of millions of dollars.
So
they sat there for 4 months silently.
We know the state assembly has issued these 20 subpoenas. I assume you're going to start issuing your own subpoenas to the same people or different people?
We hopefully will work in conjunction with one another, but we are going to start off by issuing subpoenas for documents from Chairman David Sampson's office, from Commissioner Pat Schuber's office, whom I had a personal interchange with, who promised me back in September he'd get to the bottom of this, and from the governor's incoming chief of staff, Regina Agia, who was also CC'd on some of these emails.
What kind of timeline do you expect for this investigation?
Well, you know, I'm not so sure that it's going to happen that quickly, but I would like to see us expedite it as quickly as we can to get to the real answers. And, you know, if the governor really wants to get to the bottom of this, he will urge all of the people that are surrounding him to come and tell the truth and not redact various items from emails and to come clean. I CC'd the governor on my original letter of inquiry on this, of what happened here. That's back in September. I've yet to receive an answer from the governor. Now, maybe I'm on that list that has become so infamous of all the people the governor doesn't answer. But I wrote the letter on Senate stationery. I am the majority leader of the New Jersey State Senate, and I've yet to receive an answer from any of these people.
I just want to wrap it up, Senator.
Sure.
Is there any evidence at all, anything you've seen that directly links the governor per se, the governor personally, that there is something that would suggest he has been lying over these past few days?
No, there is not any kind of direct evidence like that, except that four people around the governor, two were fired, two were forced to resign under pressure. And I believe what the governor is most responsible for is creating an environment in his office and, in fact, in political circles in our state of an environment of this kind of behavior is acceptable. That's what I think the governor needs to answer for, and I don't think he's done that yet.